Because of the fears and challenges everyone has when faced with a cancer diagnosis, Doctors Vicki Jackson and David Ryan have written a book, Living with Cancer, a step-by-step guide for coping medically and emotionally with a serious diagnosis. There's new research in the field of patient care in general, cancer care specifically. Doctors Jackson and Ryan are on the cutting edge. Their book explains how patients can work with a team of doctors, including palliative and nurse practitioners. Their goal is to minimize symptoms and side effects while a patient is living as fully as possible in the face of cancer. Vicki, would you like to pick it up there?
Sure. So we started this collaboration nearly 15 years ago now, integrating palliative care actually into the cancer center and seeing patients over the course of their illness. And we found that when patients with metastatic lung cancer were seen by palliative care monthly or as often as necessary throughout the course of their illness, that there were several really important differences in outcomes in that patient population. One was that they had an improved quality of life. A second was that they had a 50% lower rate of depression than patients who did not regularly see palliative care. We also saw that these patients lived nearly 3 months longer than patients who didn't see palliative care early on in the course of illness and regularly. So that work was really a fundamental piece of beginning this collaboration. And Dave and I have really worked to continue that integration for our patients because we feel that it's really important care for our patients and also is good for both oncology and palliative care for patients to have both of these subspecialists involved in their care.
Eventually, you have patients coming in saying, well, I'm ready to go with this trial drug and it's not been tested on humans yet.
Sometimes I drive home at night and I think to myself, gosh, that's a great drug trial. I would do that drug trial. And the next night I'll drive home and I'll say, you know what? If I were in that patient's shoes that I saw today, I think maybe I would just opt not to do that particular drug trial. I'd opt to spend whatever time I have left not coming in out of a hospital, not getting that chemotherapy. And so these are really difficult decisions that people have to make. And one decision isn't necessarily correct. And I always use the example of my mom and my dad. And my dad was a little bit of he had a gambling side to him. He'd always bet on the Kentucky Derby, and he loved to go after the long shot. For him, he would go after a phase one study. But my mom, who's very religious, would say, you know what, if the good Lord wants me to live an extra 6 months longer, I don't need your damn chemo to make that happen. And she would never do a clinical trial. And one's not right and the other's wrong. It's just who they are.
The other thing that I would add to that is deciding to do a really aggressive treatment like a clinical trial also doesn't mean that we can't still address end-of-life care if that's where the patient is at. Right. You know, like I had a patient recently who she said to me, Vicki, I would need a monkey's backside if there was any hope that I could live longer for my young kids. Like that was so critically important. And she was on hospice and on a phase one clinical trial. And so that part of this is helping understand, as Dave's saying, patients' goals and values, and for us to make recommendations to match the treatment to their goals and values so they, at the end of the day, feel like they lived their life with this cancer in a way that was really in keeping with what's important to them.
Being an oncologist, a palliative care specialist who works in the cancer space, is one of the most rewarding careers that you can have. You get to see people demonstrating enormous acts of courage, enormous acts of love and kindness. It's like living a movie every day sometimes in clinic. The interactions that you have with patients, the stories that you get are lifelong. And those stories you find yourself repeating to future patients to say how good things can sometimes turn out and how good things can be even in the face of a terrible diagnosis and a terrible prognosis.
My guests have been Doctors Vicki Jackson and David Ryan, Living with Cancer. More information at their website, livingwithcancerbook.com.